regular girl chat today, but no. Today is January 4th, which means that
it's my birthday! Yeah!
She used to say all the time, like, Meaning, we have to pretend like we're rich. People believe you look rich. You are rich.
Yeah.
You look rich. Remember?
Yeah. That's what I'm here for, movie star now.
Yes. Yeah. Clearly, I'm going for a look here with my little faux fur.
Oh, yeah.
I swear I'm Cookie Lyons over here.
Okay.
That there's a powerful effect in being able to just like put on the attitude that you want to have, even when you're not feeling it inside. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, you know, my mama taught me to wear a girdle. Okay, so I want to thank my mama for teaching me to wear a girdle, because a girdle really helps, doesn't it? I mean, you don't need it, but you know, sometimes
she wears it.
They call it yes now. They call it spank.
Yes,
the girdle.
Yes,
it's a girdle. Yes. You know. So
what did your mom teach you?
She still isn't a makeup person.
Yeah,
she doesn't like putting on a lot of makeup. She's a natural beauty. So for me, she taught me how to take care of my skin.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Drink lots of water, or if I do wear makeup, let it enhance my natural beauty, not cover it up.
Right.
Don't let the makeup wear you wear the makeup.
Yeah. Okay.
That's awesome.
What about you, sanctified and filled with the Holy Spirit, so we couldn't wear makeup, right?
Okay.
And so, you know, I had older siblings, so I would steal their makeup. I would watch what they do and steal their stuff.
Oh, okay. You were girl in school wearing the bathroom, you would sneak on a little.
I was girl in school beating my face on the bus.
Well, then here's my question. Now that we're older women, you know, are you teaching your mothers anything?
Yes. I feel like that's my thing. Like, now that I'm older, like, I try to teach my mom, like, how to put her lip liner on.
Right.
Like, she's not really into makeup like that either.
Yeah, right.
But probably all of that stuff. Like, I do my mom's makeup for holidays. Like, during Christmas and everything, I definitely did my mom's makeup.
Really good, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good.
I like makeup.
Yeah.
A lot. So I'm the one that, like, teaching her how to put on fake lashes is the mission in everything. Did your mom?
I taught her how to put on fake lashes.
Yes.
But I also taught her to get that right color, honey. Okay? That foundation.
Yes.
Sometimes it comes across real ashy.
Oh, great.
Yeah. You can't have it.
And you have to teach your mom the updated versions of, like, my mom used to put blush here, like,
yeah,
when you go like this.
Yeah.
How about that black lip liner? Anybody got that black lip liner?
Yeah. You see, Mama, my face used to.
Right, Mom? You're putting your makeup on, like, a newer style now, right?
Yes. I update right now. New stuff. Looks up.
I like your lipstick. Your lipstick.
I know. You look good. Fabulous. I mean, y'all look like sisters. You look like Mama.
For Jeannie teaching me?
Yeah.
For right now, she want mom, whatever, you know, when you go out there, make it look soft, make it look nice, don't put too much makeup, no?
Mm-hmm.
Look ugly, look like a hooker.
Well,
good advice, Jeannie.
Yes.
Very good advice.
I used other words, but I guess it came through like that.
Parents say to their kids can have a lasting impact even at a young age.
Mm-hmm.
A new study published in the Journal of Experimental Social Psychology suggests that children can have a fully formed sense of self-esteem by the age of 5.
Wow.
Yes. So we have to watch what we're teaching our kids, explaining to our kids.
I believe that.
So Tamar, are you already working on building up Logan's self-esteem?
Absolutely.
Yes.
To start, you know what I mean? The younger, the better.
Right.
You know what I mean? You have to instill them that you can be, you can do whatever you want to do.
Yeah.
I find myself with Aiden. He's in his terrible 2 phase right now.
Mm-hmm.
He can be, you know, very.
Terrible. Yeah.
Yes. But instead of saying, "Oh, Aiden, you're so difficult right now," I say, "Aiden, you're being very challenging for me right now.
You choose your words.
You have to choose your words wisely because, like the study says, they're listening, they're learning."
Mama, how do you feel, about this? I mean, when you tell us the truth about Jeannie growing up.
Let me tell you something about it, Jew. Okay, I'm lucky. My 3 kids, especially Jeannie Mai, when she's about 2 or 3 years old, she jump up the table. And she put the towel over, you know, like an Egyptian girl, and dancing and singing in front of the people.
Uh-huh.
So she's very good about that, so I don't have to worry. But I'm trying to say, if she has a problem, like you say, I want to encourage her.
Encourage
her to make her, you know, better.
Yeah,
a better impact. But you really were never shy.
But you never
know. But I think that's another thing, too. When you're parents, I see it in public sometimes when a kid belts out in song or dances by themselves.
They get embarrassed.
When the parents go, no, behave, you know, control yourself. Then I see that kid all of a sudden aware of insecurity and shame.
Yes. It looks like as a parent, you're embarrassed by their child, and they're just trying to express themselves.
Yeah. Right. That's a long time ago, Asian style like that.
What I tell Aiden when we're outside and, you know, he's yelling, what I say is, Aiden, inside voice. Use your inside voice, not your outside voice.
He's learning it.
Except when you're in church, you get that pinch, though.
Wait, do you pinch Logan?
What?
Girl, you ain't seen nothing. She pinched me and Logan at the same time.
No, I'm talking about when your mama used to pinch you.
Oh, my mom used to go up with it. She used to go like this and then go up. And then she still had to be quiet while she's doing it at the same time.
That is challenging, right?
How about when they turn to you? Like, for me, we'll say it in another language, but when they say, like, they're acting everything's normal, and then they go,
yes.
When you get home.
Yeah.